Hello everyone, I'm Krati Jain. I'm going to share the experience from a pilot project on real-time screening and monitoring on child malnutrition conducted by ICDS team in Jhansi. It was conducted under the leadership of Mr. Nikhil Funde, then CDO of Jhansi, and me as a technical implementation resource person, then working as a Swasth Bharat Prerak in Jhansi. So as we all know that malnutrition is a grave issue in our country. Lancet study shows that 68% of under 5 deaths and 83% of neonatal death happens due to child and maternal malnutrition. Therefore, correct screening and monitoring of malnutrition becomes very important to avoid these deaths. Growth monitoring is fundamental to identification of three indicators of malnutrition, that is underweight, stunting, and wasting. However, there is a huge gap in accuracy and timely measurement of growth parameters at the grassroots level due to lack of capacity of Anganwadi workers, unavailability of growth monitoring devices, challenges of manual tracking of each children, and human error. Additionally, the collection and analysis of this dynamic data becomes very time consuming if done manually and often fails to reach the convergent departments for timely interventions as required under Poshan Abhiyan. Therefore, use of technology was explored in Jhansi. The proposed system consists of two parts. One is the EPGM machine, which is a smart scale as you can see here, and second is a real-time monitoring dashboard called MA. How it works is very simple. Growth of a child is measured using the EPGM machine, and that data is transferred to the dashboard through either SMS, internet, or USB drive. The dashboard analyzes the data and sends the list of all malnourished children under each category to various officials of all convergent departments. It also sends SMS to parents and Anganwadi workers. It also generates a number of reports and trends that can be assessed by decision makers and policy experts. Interventions like counseling, continued poshahar, toilet, job card, ration card, etc. done for each identified children is also fed into the system by concerned department to track the progress. So it links all the aspects and binds it in one synchronized screening and response system. So this system was piloted in 10 Anganwadi centers that were selected in Badagaon block of Jhansi for 3 months, in which 3 rounds of training and on-ground testing was conducted with the support of Niti Raj Engineering Limited and Tumas Foundation. Anganwadi workers were able to operate the machines very easily, and they said it made their process very easy. In the 3rd month, the coverage of 95% children was achieved, and the percentage malnutrition that was recording during the pilot came out to be double the average rate when the screening was done manually, which was indicative of the maximizing reach and accuracy in measurement. Plus, we could have all the aggregated charts and reports of all individual children as shown here in just one click. This is how the dashboard looks, which gives a real-time data on all three indicators segregated at all levels with filters of age, sex, month, location, etc. We realized that with this system, we could complete the entire screening with accuracy within the first 7 days of every month, leaving the remaining 3 weeks for frontline workers for just focused intervention and reviews, resulting in a better organized system. With a clear list of SAN children referred to NRC increase, and we could do the focus counseling for each individual. In terms of policy implication, we understand that screening of malnutrition is the first step towards eradicating it. Therefore, capturing timely and correct data is very crucial that needs a policy nudge. If we can replace our regular growth monitoring device with such smart scale, it can ease the operation of Anganwadi workers, identify malnutrition correctly, and enable data-driven decision making. This technology also binds the interventions of all convergence department, which is currently a challenge to track. So the huge amount of data reporting that happens through manual system takes up a lot of work hours of Anganwadi workers, supervisors, CDPO and DPOs. With the use of such technology, this time can be saved and used for intervention on ground with children. I would like to conclude by saying that small and one-time investment in technology can create a long-term big impact and help us track each and every child so that no one is left behind. Thank you.